Hello students, welcome back to the next topic of basic electrical and electronics engineering. We are discussing about DC machines, and now in this session I am going to visit a next numerical from our syllabus, and that is nothing but a DC series motor. I, Professor Pritesh Vibhute, once again welcome you to solve a numerical related to DC motor. I already told you that numerical related to DC motors are very important. At least there will be one numerical based on DC motor, either series or shunt, in any examination, that is in same or end same examination. So please pay 100% attention. Now see, try to understand the problem statement. A four pole, okay, first parameter given over here is P is equal to 4. DC series, okay, they asked us that this is a DC series motor. So DC series motor looks something like this, where this is then field winding and this is an armature winding. So if I put an equivalent circuit, it will look something like this. So this is a VB, that is a brush losses, then this is IARA, and that then next is EB. EB is a back EMF. So this is an armature equivalent circuit and this is an field circuit IF, okay, or rather RF, field winding. And then this is an voltage up input applied voltage V over here. And please note that as there is only one loop, and that's why IF is equal to IA is equal to I. Total current I is nothing but a current through field winding as well as current through armature winding. So these are the important point to be note before proceeding further for solving this numerical. So this is DC series motor. Okay, now let's proceed to the next parameter. The first parameter they have given, okay, I will write the given parameter over here. P is equal to 4, the first parameter that they have given, I have written over here. Then next one is 944 conductors are there. So that is nothing but Z is equal to 944. But those conductors are connected in wave fashion, that is nothing but A is equal to, in case of wave fashion, it is 2. In case of a lap winding, it is A is always equal to P, that is nothing but 4. Then conductor having a flux per pole, that is nothing but phi. Phi is equal to 36.4 into 10 raised to minus 3. Why I have written minus 3? Because it is in a milliweber. Then, and gross torque means they have given a TA. TA is equal to 209 nanometer. Calculate armature current, that is nothing but IA is how much? That is the first question, as well as speed. They are asking us to calculate how much is N. If a supply voltage is, means they have given V, V is equal to 500. Don't get confused with the V or EB. It is supply voltage, not generated voltage or back EMF. Okay. And armature resistance is, that is RA, is equal to 3 ohm. So this is the list of all entities given in a numerical. Now let's proceed and try to solve it. We have two most important equations. EB is equal to P phi NZ divided by 60A. And second most important equation, T is equal to 1 upon 2 pi, TA is nothing but torque, into P phi Z IA divided by A. So these are the two important equations. Okay, now let's take a equation of TA and try to put a values. Do I know the value of TA? Yes, it is 209. Okay, I have written the first value of TA, 209. Do I know the value of 1 upon 2 pi? Yes, it is 1 upon 2 pi only. Multiplied by, do I know the value of P? Yes, it is 4. Let's put it over here, 4. Do I know the value of phi? Yes, it is 36.4 into 10 raised to minus 3. Do I know the value of Z? Yes, it is 944. Then next, do I know the value of I? No, but that is what we need to calculate. So put it as it is, divided by, do I know the value of A? Yes, A is equal to 2. So put it over here. So 2 2s are 4 and these 2 cancel. Now keep IA on one side and transfer all entity on other side. IA is equal to 209 multiplied by pi, because this numerator will become denominator will become numerator, divided by 36.4. then see, 10 raised to minus 3 at the bottom will go 10 raised to minus 3 at the top, so we can write it as like 1000 divided by 944. So this is the value. Now let me put it in a calculator and solve it. Okay, I am pressing and control R to open a red panel and then enter a command for calculator as calc. Now calculator is already open. Now let's put the values in the calculator. Okay, so the values I will put it like this. First of all, let me shift the calculator. 209 multiplied by pi, that is 3.14 multiplied by 1000. So 1000, so that is our numerator that we calculated. Okay, let me check everything is all right or not. 209 multiply by pi, and then this is divide, and at the top of it is will be okay, look like promising. Now divided by 36.4 and then divided by 944. So the current calculated IA is equal to 19.09 ampere. Now let me write it over here. IA is almost equal to 19.09 ampere. 09 ampere. So this is how I have calculated, and first entity that is nothing but IA, and calculated value of IA is 19.0986. That is nothing but we can write it like 19.1 ampere also. We can write it like 19.1 ampere also. Okay, so we have successfully calculated the first value IA. Now let's proceed to calculator N. So to calculator N, we can use this particular equation, but again for this equation we required a EB. Do I have a value of EB over here? No. But I can apply and KVL over here and calculate a value of a EB. How? Just very simple. V is equal to minus, or okay, now let me write a complete equation. We will start from this particular point and we will assume a current as a IA, and start from this point and let's go over here. Minus IARF minus VB, but VB is not given in problem statement, so we can ignore it. Minus IARA, then again this is plus or minus, so this is again minus EB, then this is plus V. So if I transfer V on another side, this will be V is equal to minus, or rather plus, IARA plus IARF plus EB. So from this formula we can calculate EB. So that will be equal to 500 is equal to, let me take a IA common, that is 19.09 or 19.1 in bracket RA plus RF. How much is RA? RA is 3, but do we have a RF given over here? No. So let's assume it as a 0. Then plus EB. So EB is equal to 500 minus 19.1 into 3. Let's put it 19.09 multiplied by 3. So that comes up to be 57.29. Now subtract it from 500. So minus 500. So that's why we got is a 442.70. So EB is equal to 442.70. So that is how we calculated EB in volt. Now put it in this particular equation, we will get a value of N. So that is how it will be something like this. 442.70 is equal to 4 into 36.4 into 10 raised to power minus 3 multiplied by N. N is the one which we need to calculate, multiplied by Z. Z is nothing but 944 divided by 60 into A. So 60 into A is 2. So 2 2's are 4, then 2, and this will become 30. Now let's simplify it. I will calculate it on a calculator and then we will get a value of N. Okay. So I performed a calculation and I found out a value of a speed, that is N is equal to 386.5 revolution per minute. Okay, have you understood this? So this is how we can calculate the value of N, that is the speed of rotation of this particular motor. So this is how we can solve a numerical related to DC series motor and DC shunt motor. We will practice few more numerical in live sessions now. Till then, please be safe and enjoy this session. Thank you.